Hello and welcome to the new series of Drishti IAS. I'm Pooja Dwivedi, and in this segment today we are going to discuss about US withdrawal of combat troops from Afghanistan that is going to affect each country that is surrounding Afghanistan. This topic is important from the perspective of prelims and very important from the perspective of GS Mains Paper 2 because this is going to be a revolutionary step that is going to change the contemporary world scenario. Moving on, let's talk about the points of discussion. This is going to be the entire structure that we are going to follow. The best step. So why news? Because the Biden administration has said that it is going to withdraw the remaining amount of troops by September 11, 2021. Interestingly, this is going to be the 20th anniversary of the calamitous 9/11 attacks. Now, if we talk about what is going to be the procedure ahead, in March, as we all know, that the Secretary of State, Antony Blinken, had proposed a plan that is dead in the water. It talked about a 90-day ceasefire, talks under the aegis of UN with various stakeholders such as Russia, US, China, Iran, Pakistan, India. Also talked about a political consensus between Taliban, the Afghan government, and the US. But now, if we talk about the current scenario, the Biden administration says that we are going to withdraw the troops, but we will still be in a process of building a political consensus. Now, as we all know, the 24th of April has been selected as a date in Turkey for a meeting with Taliban. But Taliban is altogether in a different zone now. It is saying that according to the Doha Agreement, it was said by the 1st of May, the remaining troops of the US that are about 2,500 to 3,500 right now, boots on ground, plus under 8,000 that Alliance of NATO has provided in Afghanistan, it will be withdrawn. But it has not withdrawn up to this date, and a new date has been promised. Now, the Taliban is saying that this is the defiance of the Doha Accord, and whatever the consequences are going to be there, the US will have to bear with it, and the US has the entire responsibility for it. Moving on, let's talk about Afghanistan. Afghanistan, which is a country in Central Asia known as the Empire of Graveyards. It is actually surrounded by countries such as Iran, Pakistan, India, Tajikistan, Turkmenistan, and Uzbekistan. So, not only Afghanistan is going to be affected by this, but all these countries which are surrounding Afghanistan are going to be affected by this. Moving on, let's talk about the background. What actually has led to this scenario? Let's go back to that day of September, if we talk about which date, September 11, which is known as the 9/11. After the attacks of 9/11, the US administration asked the Taliban for Osama bin Laden, but they refused to hand him over, and that is why a US-led invasion was launched in response to it. And after that, not only the US launched an attack, but NATO, the allies of NATO, also did the same. After that, the Taliban leadership quickly lost control of the country and relocated to southern Afghanistan and across the borders to Pakistan. From there, they continued their retaliation and offensive against the democratic government and the US troops plus the NATO troops. After a period of time, it was said that the entire war has come to a stalemate. There was not win-win or lose-lose or win-or-lose situation for either Taliban or the US or its allies. So then comes the accord, the US-Taliban peace accord, which was a negotiation between US and Taliban. It began in September 2018. And if we talk about the features of the deal, it promised troops withdrawal by May 1st of 2021 by the Trump administration. And Taliban also committed that it will not let the use of the soil of Afghanistan to launch offensives against the US or the US allies. And there were also promises of sanctions removal from Taliban by the UN and its allies as well. And there was also said that there is going to be a prisoner release swap. Whatever the prisoners of war were captured by the US will be swapped with Taliban. Now, there were certain challenges to the deal. It was seen as a one-sided deal because America or the US and its allies were ready to lose everything, but Taliban had possibilities of gaining the lost territories. There were also issues with inter-Afghan dialogue because the legitimate government was sidelined. And that is why it said that we have a problem with prisoner swap as well, because this right actually lies with the legitimate government, the Afghan government. But they were feeling sidelined because Taliban was directly into the picture with the US, but Afghan government, the legitimate democratic government, was not. So this was the entire scenario. Now let's talk about Afghanistan. Now if we talk about the Long War Journal of the US, it is saying that out of 325 districts of Afghanistan, right now approximately 19%, that is 76 districts, are under Taliban. And out of 325 districts, 127, that is 32% of districts, are with the Afghan government. Other districts are contested. Now the problem here lies that once the troops have kind of abandoned Afghanistan right now, what will happen? Taliban may again start recapturing by undemocratic and violent means the contested regions or even the regions that are under the Afghan government. Moving on, let's talk about what is the Biden's revised plan. It has proposed that a UN-led conference of representatives of Russia, China, Pakistan, Iran, and the US to discuss a unified approach to support peace in Afghanistan. Talks to be accelerated between Afghan leadership and Taliban because they are running out of time. Also to find a roadmap to a new inclusive government, that is, Taliban should also be included, it was said by Russia and many stakeholders as well, and agree on the terms of permanent and comprehensive ceasefire. So, the impacts of the withdrawal of troops that has officially been announced are going to be many. First, for Afghanistan, because there is an ominous uncertainty. Nothing is known what is going to happen. Will Taliban actually abide by the universal laws, by democratic laws? It is not being seen because the country is close to losing. It is being seen by the Afghan government. That is, the country is close to losing all the gains that it has done, it has been getting since the last 15 years. Now, there is also a view that says that Taliban too has changed over the last 25 years, and it does not want to alienate the international community like it did earlier. But there is no consensus over election. Now, if we talk about the legitimate Afghan government, it also talked about that we are ready to have elections if Taliban wants to have it. But Taliban has said that it is not in the interest of Taliban. And they have also called it that the Afghan government is actually a puppet government of the US. For Pakistan, there are certain gains and certain concerns because it says, the analysts have said, that if Taliban captures power in Afghanistan, now there will be a friendly government reinstated in Afghanistan, and that will make India to be sidelined, because India has terms not with Taliban but with the legitimate government. India would be cut to size. Second problem is that because Pakistan has the entire responsibility to shoulder the entire burden of the chaos, because civil war cannot be ruled out. This could happen, and Pakistan is already dealing with the refugees of the Afghan war, and it is having a low economic capacity. It is afloat on an IMF loan with strict conditions. So is Pakistan ready for it? It's not known yet. China would have much to lose because of the China-Pakistan economic corridor. Now, because China is an ally of Pakistan, it could see a bigger role for itself in Afghanistan, and we all know how aggressively China is expanding its hands, its muscles, how much of flexing of muscles is taking place for China. Also, if Taliban wants to, it can stir the Xinjiang district of Xinjiang autonomous region of China because of the minority Uyghur Muslims living there. That could also be a problem according to analysts. Also, if we talk about Russia in recent years, Russia has actually been more of a peacemaker in Afghanistan. But Russia's growing links with Pakistan, it can translate into a post-US role for Russia and Afghanistan. If we talk about Iran, Iran is sharing border both with Pakistan and Afghanistan, and that is why it is perceiving active security threats from both. Moving on, if we talk about India, India wanted a bigger role, wanted to go beyond the development role because the Blinken proposal gave India a role by recognizing it as a regional stakeholder, and it is a regional stakeholder. But the problem is that the situation is grim because the Haqqani group fostered by the ISI, it would have a larger role in any Taliban regime. Also, India-focused militants as Laskar-e-Toyba and Jaish-e-Mohammed, which the Indian security establishment already believes to have relocated in larger numbers in Afghanistan if they are stirred by China and Pakistan, this could be a threat to India. Let's move forward and talk about the way forward now. If we talk about US, US is although withdrawing its troops, but it is going to remain deeply engaged with the Afghan government and remains committed to the Afghan people. The necessity is to track, keep on tracking and disrupting the terrorist networks that spread far beyond Afghanistan. It also wants to shore up US competitiveness to face an increasingly assertive China. Now there is going to be a power vacuum soon in Afghanistan, and US is going to be very, very vigilant when it comes to China. China has a lot of interest in Central Asia. It also wants to work with democratic allies, such as India, of course, and partners to confront the challenges of emerging technologies and, of course, defeat the present pandemic. Moving on, let's talk about our main space question. What are the challenges that Afghan will face post-US exit, and how should India prepare for it? So, kindly write it down in 250 words. That's it for today. Tomorrow we shall meet again with another segment. Until then, stay updated. And thank you so much for watching.